Hi, I'm Peter Wade, I'm UK Sales Manager for Megger, and today I'm here with Pass in one of their work bays just to show you how to do a continuity test using the Megger MFT X1. The continuity test is a test that is done to prove that there's no breaks in the circuit. It can be done on earth path, it can be done on live, it can be done on neutral, but it is a dead test, so we need no power on the circuits at all. It's usually done mainly when you're installing new circuits and if you're doing ERCRs when you're going back to a property and need to do a continuity of circuit on tests. You can also use it to ensure that you've got the switches in the correct line and not in the neutral line, so they switch off the power and not the neutral. So first thing we can do, we've got a powered board here. We need to turn that off. Quick bit of safe isolation to ensure there is no power at all anywhere on the board, and then I'll show you a couple of simple tests using the X1 for continuity. So first off, we turn all the units off, so we know that it's off from that point of view, but we do know that the power is being supplied here. So to ensure that we do it correctly, we will take the panel off first. We know that I switched everything off, so therefore there's no power to the circuits, but there is still power coming to the main incoming part. It could be a main switch or, in this case, it's an RCD. So to do safe isolation, we need to use a proving unit and a two-pole tester or a voltage indicating device. The first thing we need to do is make sure this is working correctly. So using the proving unit, as you can see, it's working and gives me an indication of voltage. I now check for voltage first. So I will go live coming in to earth, and I've got a voltage. Okay, and also live to neutral, we know there's a voltage there, so that's fine, that's there. I now need to isolate that. This is the isolating device here, so I turn it off. I would need to lock that out with a padlock if I was in a different room or a different part of the building to make it safe that no one else can then switch it on by accident. But as I'm here and I know I'm by myself, I'm happy to leave that as is. I just do them same tests again, so I just check that my meter is working. Yes, that's working fine. I go onto my live, no noise already, no indication voltage across live, and no of neutral. So I can safely say that that is now dead. So I can now do my continuity testing with the X1. So the X1, we put the setting to continuity, okay. The leads have already been nulled, and I am using the same lead, so I've already got a value in there. I now need to connect into the circuit. So as I said, a continuity is just a test that improves that there's no break in a connection. So if we look, we've got some earth pipes here, some earth pipes there. We'll check that all the bonding is correct. So connect my earth wire and my positive wire in, or positive and negative in this case. If I put my clip onto the earth bar, we have an auto start feature on this, which means I don't need to press my test buttons with the X1, I just need to make a contact. So I can go onto this connection here, and you can see a value. In fact, I'll just turn the noise on so you'll hear it better. Okay, that's connected to earth. I'm gonna pan over here now, and this copper pipe here also. Well, I'm getting a reading, but not a bleep. There we go, just a contact. So now we know that all the bonding is connected here. Now, we've got sockets in there at the moment. So we've proved that we've got continuity of the earthing on extraneous parts like radiator pipes and water pipes. We can also use in the MSA 1363 socket adapter, check for this, the earth in the sockets as well. And as you can see, we've got a value, which is fine, but we've got the noise that we know we've got that connection. So I can just disconnect that. We also have lighting adapters for lighting circuits where we can do the same thing as well. So depending on what sort of testing you're doing, we have the different adapters for that. We can also prove, if we go back to the board, we can also do the neutral because we know it's dead. If we connect onto the neutral side of the board, and then come and into the neutral side, we can prove continuity in the neutral and we can do continuity of the live that you can hear as well. So using this adapter is a simple way of proving that there's no breaks in the circuits. Thanks for watching the video, hope you enjoyed it. I've done a number of other videos for RCD installation and earth loop impedance testing as well. The link should be appearing on the screen now. If you have any questions or comments, you can put them into the box below, and a member of the PALS team will get back to you. Thank you for your time.